Welcome back to EnergyPlus for Beginners. In the last video, we modeled the geometry of a very simple energy model. And in this video, we are going to assign the materials and constructions for this building energy model. So let's assign the construction for walls, floor, and ceilings. Okay, so I'm going to go to our model for the last video, and I'm going to open it with IDF editor. And here, if I press Ctrl L, EnergyPlus will shrink down all classes of objects. And here I can see that in building surface detail, I have all surfaces that compound our building. So I have a ceiling, a floor, and walls for each one of our thermal zones. Remember, we have three thermal zones, one for the living room, one for the bedroom, one for the bathroom. To add materials, we want to go to the class material, okay, and we create new objects here. So by creating a new object, I already have one prepared here. You just like assign a new object there. And what we need to do is to establish the name of this material. So let's say material one, and you want to specify the roughness of this material. The roughness is related to the texture of the material, and it will impact the convective factor, the convective heat exchange. So let's say that we have our material is rough, and the thickness of our material, so this is actually a layer of material that we are assigning. So let's say that our thickness is 0.1, and then we need to assign the thermal properties of this material. So thermal properties are defined on standards or in manufacturer's specification. So we have to know from your design, your building plan, what are the material, and you have to search for the thermal properties of these materials. So here I am using these thermal properties. For example, thermal conductivity 1.75, the density 2200, and the specific heat 1000, and thermal absorptance, solar absorptance, and visible absorptance already specified in default. So this is the thermal properties of a concrete. So this material actually is concrete. 10 centimeters layers of concrete. Okay, so I can delete this one, and I have set a layer of concrete here. Okay, so how I can transform this into a construction? So if we go to the class construction, what we can do is to assign layers in a specific order to say that there is a construction. For example, this is the construction of the floor, and the construction of the floor can start with a layer of concrete from the outside to inside. So if we do something like this, we are telling EnergyPlus that the floor is made of 10 centimeters of concrete. Then what we have to do is to assign these constructions to the building surface that represents the floor. So we are going to building surface detail. And here, one where it says a construction name, we're going to look for the floors. For example, this object is a floor, and we're going to assign the construction name of floor here. Okay, so this is, in this way, we are saying that this surface here, this is a surface, a geometric element, is compound of 10 centimeters of concrete. That's what it means. So there is some specific elements that we want to also work off on with materials. So I'm going to press Ctrl L again. And here we can see that there is material no mass. This class of materials, you can add one, and it's related to insulation. So every time we work with insulation, you're going to add in material no mass. Again, we need to specify the roughness. So let's say that it's medium smooth. And we need to specify the thermal resistance. So insulation are materials that have very low density and a lot of thermal resistance. So this why they have a specific class for insulation. So let's say that our insulation has a thermal resistance of 2 square meter Kelvin per watts, and that's it. So now we also can have, I press Ctrl L again, we can go to construction, and if we want, we can add a layer of insulation here. And let's just for fun put another layer of concrete. Now we are saying that our floor has an insulation layer between two layers of concrete. So since we don't mess with the name here, we can we can just leave that way, or otherwise, if I want to just maintain the other first floor construction, I can just duplicate it. And here I can, for example, rename this object first floor insulated. And then if I want to go back to this building surface detail, if I want to set this floor, this surface as an insulated floor, I can choose here floor insulated. Okay, so another property that is important to show is here in material, we have material air gap. So material air gap is similar to material no mass. It's something that is just, we are just adding a thermal resistance in the materials layers. So if I can create an object here, and I'm going to write a name for air gap, for example, and I'm just adding a thermal resistance of 0.5, for example, I'm just guessing this thermal resistance. The actual values for thermal resistance for air gaps, you can find in specific standards. For example, the standard 10453-2022, it gathers a lot of thermal properties for several materials and also for air gaps. So now if we can, for example, want to build another construction for a floor with a layer of air gaps, we can also duplicate it and create a floor with air gap, for example, and instead of insulation, I can select an air gap here. And then if I want to assign this object to this construction to a surface, I can go to building surface detail. And again, instead of floor insulated, floor with air gap. So this is the way that we assign materials and arrange them in constructions by layers. And then we assign these constructions to each one of the surfaces that compounds of building surface detail. Next video, we're going to talk about constructions for windows, fenestrations, and doors.